effective digestion? Give it to me straight, Hannah. I swallowed my gum. That's a sticky situation. I heard on the news it'll be in there 7 years. Is that true? I'll get to the bottom of this. Or my name isn't Detective Digestion. I can't wait. Gum. It comes in different shapes, sizes, and colors. 100,000 tons of gum are chewed every year around the world. That's about the same weight as a blue whale. That's a lot of gum, by gum. Why do you chew gum?
I think you chew gum because to get your jaws exercised.
People just chew gum for fun.
They think it's fun and they can blow bubbles.
They might like the flavor, or it's because they like gum.
It has a good flavor and it might taste really good.
Sometimes gum can smell good and you need your breath to smell good, not bad.
Because it's exercise for your mouth and because it's fun.
When there's no flavor, they just throw it out.
Fun fact, gum was invented by accident. Imagine this.
A mad scientist named Walter Diemer concocted bubblegum in his laboratory while trying to make a gum that wasn't too sticky. An extra dash of glucose and it was alive!
Okay, it wasn't that dramatic. Walter was a scientist, like the rest of us. Actually, he was an accountant. Just goes to show we can all do science anytime. The only color Walter had on hand was pink, so he added it to make the goo more appealing. That's how gum got its classic pink color.
Do you think it's good?
I did some sleuthing, Hannah. Tell me! No. I'll show you. As you chewed your tasty gum, your saliva began to break down the sugar and flavoring agents. The gum probably became bland, and you decided to swallow it. Fair enough! The gum passed through your esophagus, or as I say when I'm off science duty, the old food elevator, and down to your stomach. But gum is made of rubber, which is a polymer. That's right, long chains of atoms strung together. And those polymers are insoluble. That's right, can't be broken down. Like any other insoluble food, for example, my high fiber lunch. That's right, I love broccoli. The gum will simply pass through your small intestine, large intestine, and out.
You mean?
Yep. Sorry to burst your bubble, kid. Still fresh. Yuck. Experiment time. For this experiment, you just need 3 small sticks of gum and a freezer. Place 1 stick on the counter and the other 2 inside the freezer. Wait a while and think about all the science you can do with a freezer.
You could freeze water, a bouncy ball, a balloon. Air inside a balloon. A bubble? A baseball. Slime you made while learning about tears and snot.
Take out 1 of the frozen gum sticks and put it in your mouth. How does it feel? Is it easy or hard to chew it? What happens as you keep chewing? Now take that out and put it somewhere safe, like a trash can, and try the piece you left on the countertop. Is it easier or harder to chew it? Gum gets softer as you chew it. Why? Those long chains of atoms are tangled together, so the rubber can bounce and stretch when you pull it.
But when it's cold, those atoms are closer together and they can't stretch as much. Take out that third piece from the freezer, you can snap it in half. Not bendy at all. Rubber gets bendier as it warms up, and your mouth is like a tiny gum oven. It's about 98 degrees Fahrenheit in there, which is like a hot summer day in your mouth. Oh my gum! Who knew there was so much science in something so delicious? Something delicious, anyway. What do you think, scientist?